Welcome back, everyone. Spinning Mantis, Squirt Reynolds, with some more of the Long Dark Wintermute Redo, Episode 1. We just tried to record something, and the application crashed.
Boo.
So we
crash location.
We just ran into the house.
You're all, hello.
Into the Milton house.
Oh, hey.
And I have the motion sickness, like, filter on now, so it shouldn't, like, I shouldn't be able to, like, look around, like, too fast. It should be a little bit better.
Thanks. Is he bird boxing? Is that what that's called?
Hey. Hey, wake up. Holy shit! Wait! Hold your fire!
Get back.
Okay. Just take it easy.
Why are you here?
I saw the smoke from your chimney.
Outsider.
What?
Thought so. Mainlander. Outsider. I don't recognize your voice. And you haven't left like the others. So, must be a mainlander. Someone who doesn't know any better.
My plane, I crashed in the mountains nearby. I'm looking for someone who crashed with me. A friend. She might be injured.
I haven't seen her.
Well, you haven't seen anything because you got your eyes covered.
Could you maybe point that gun someplace else?
You think? Because my eyes are covered, I can't see you. Make the wrong move, say the wrong thing. You'll see how good a shot I am.
Can you tell me what the wrong thing is?
I don't doubt it.
The others are all gone.
Okay.
If you're here, things must be worse than they thought.
So,
what do you want to ask?
Who are you?
Name's Mackenzie, by the way. And you are?
I had a name once. But for years, the townsfolk have called me Grey Mother. A name takes on its own life. Such that at one point, the name becomes the thing it belongs to. Then the old names fade. Can only be remembered by the young and the true.
So, I should call you...
Mother!
You should call me Grey Mother also.
Okay.
She's a bad Grey Mother. Shut your mouth.
Sitting here with a rifle in your hand. You expecting trouble?
Trouble? Trouble found me.
You mean the storm?
The bad men came. Took my things. Tried to take my house. They thought they were safe. Because Grey Mother can't see. They were wrong.
Okay, this bad man.
Who are the bad men?
The men they passed through town. The night of the storm. The night of the lights.
How'd you see?
I'm looking for my friend. She crashed with me when my plane came down in the mountains. Do you think she could have come through and been caught by these bad men?
Wait, was that before?
I can't say for sure. Is your friend a survivor?
Yes.
She's a survivor.
Then there is always hope.
Okay.
Where are we?
Milton. A forgotten town, deep in the mountains. You're far from home.
But Where are we on Great Bear? My plane came down in a storm, and my compass was acting funny.
I've lived here all my life. Not much use for the outside world. Milton's the last of the old mountain towns. Now, it's almost impossible to get to or get out of. Only people left here are either too poor or too proud to leave.
Which are you?
I have what I need. At least I did before the bad men came. Now I'm not sure I have enough to get through the winter.
I need to find my friend, but I'll do what I can to help.
My mind is fuzzy. Something come through so sharp. Like a dream. Let me think. Let me rest. Maybe I can pull some memories out of the fog. Maybe I can find something that could help you find your friend.
Okay.
The bad men. Did they try to hurt you?
Everyone thinks being old means you're weak. But they underestimated Grandmother.
It seems they did.
All right, what should we ask her next?
Empty? What does empty mean?
I think maybe the town is empty.
The town seems so quiet. Does anyone still live here?
Not many. After the earthquakes, less. After last night, even fewer.
Where did everyone go?
That I cannot say.
Can't say or won't say.
All I know is that I heard screams and could smell smoke for most of the night.
You mentioned smelling smoke.
Someone came here. One of the townsfolk. Tried to convince me to leave. They said there were houses burning in the town. They said people were scared and were leaving for the coast. On foot. Foolish plan. But that's what they said to do. After the quakes, if there was ever another emergency, go to the coast and help will come. They wanted me to go with them. But I'm not ready to leave Milton.
They left you here? Alone?
I'm not alone. I have my Lily.
Lily?
Never mind.
It's my shotgun.
I crashed without much food or gear myself. And if these bad men cleaned you out, we're gonna need to find some food and fuel, or neither of us is gonna make it through the next few days. You have any idea where we could find some supplies?
The bad men took everything. And the others in town who would have helped me are gone. The ones left will have their own worries. It's up to you, outsider.
I'll do what I can, but I'll need your help. There must be somewhere in town to get food, fuel, the essentials.
What about your friend? Aren't you in a hurry to find her?
Yes, I am. And I'll be looking for signs of her. There's a lot of ground to cover. Without gear, I won't make it. So while I'm looking for supplies, you see what you can remember about the Night of the Lights, and if she might have passed through town. That way, maybe we can help each other.
Okay. outsider. Grandmother can't promise she can unlock the secrets in the dark cupboards of her mind. But she'll try.
Okay.
Right.
What really happened here? Seems like people were here recently. Where did they go? Why didn't they call for help? Just drive out.
The power went out. Who knows the reason? People started to get cold, hungry.
Hangry.
They panicked. Started to talk crazy. Others walked here from the highway. Some belonged here. Others were outsiders, like you.
Did anyone see a woman? Brown hair, would have had a tan jacket, a scarf with birds on it.
Put a bird on it.
Astrid's a hipster.
Mm-hmm. Was an outsider woman. I heard her pass through. She wasn't alone. There were angry voices and... But the storm was too loud.
Voices?
I lost the voices, and I couldn't get them back.
Okay.
Okay. Well, any idea how I can get out of this town? I need to find help.
The old quake closed down most of the roads in and out of town. That was years ago. Blizzard just swept through town after the power went out. As for hell, you won't find any out there. You're on your own. We both are.
The power seems out all over town.
The power's always been spotty here. Since the quakes. No money to fix the broken stuff left behind. And nobody from the mainland seemed to care enough to do anything about it.
I'm sure someone will come and fix it.
Sure.
Nobody's coming to save Milton.
How can you be so sure?
I've learned to hear the difference between something quiet and something abandoned. This goes deeper. Than just a stillness. It feels like the moments before the world goes to sleep. We're just the last ones left to wait to notice it.
You keep calling me a mainlander. Why?
Because you're from the mainland,
That's
right?
That's what you are, isn't it? From the mainland. An outsider. You don't really belong here, do you?
Hey, but you sound bitter about it.
We lost everything in the collapse. People didn't realize how dependent we'd become. Some were fine with it. Others didn't want the scraps from your table. Created deep rifts in families, communities. Scars that never heal. The mainland had become our lifeline, and it was suddenly... cut. And so, we suffered.
I guess I don't know much about that history.
I'm not surprised. You mainlanders have always been focused on your own story. Only interested in Great Bear when it had something to give you. If you can't cut it down or dig it out of the ground, what use is it to you?
All right, last one.
Before... You mentioned hearing voices. Do you remember what you heard?
Memories are gray, misty. I'm trying to remember. It was windy. The blizzard was already waking up. But I heard yelling. A scream.
Was it a woman's voice?
I'm not sure. The voices were thin, far. Blizzard was waking up. Soon there was only wind and darkness. I don't know. I don't remember. It's all cloudy now.
All right, that looks like... Okey-doke.
Well, there you have it.
Everything you can say to her and kind of like look around. But that's a good place to stop this one. Join us next time. We will probably try to recover from our injuries and then move into the next part of the story. Check out that bloody corpse that was outside that we had to run past on our way in. But anyway, that's all for now. Bye.
Bye.